Hey everyone and welcome to Photoshop Pro Help, and today I'll be teaching this really cool realistic rainbow. Now all you really need for this effect is just your image that you want to apply the effect to. So let's just have a look at the rainbow itself. Now this image here is pretty dark, so the rainbow had to be darkened to suit the actual image. Now your images might vary, it might be lighter, it might be darker, so you really have to play around with the levels and the effects on this to suit your image. So let's just jump over to the other image here. Now this is a lot lighter, as I said, you have to play around with the levels and stuff. But you can have the rainbow as big as you want and as thick as you want, and how many rainbows you want to put in your image. So let's jump into things. So we've got our image already loaded into Photoshop. Now it's pretty easy from here. All you want to go do is go to the bottom right hand side and click the new layer icon. And from here we're just going to go and go to the gradient tool on the left hand side. Now it might be hiding underneath the paint bucket tool, so don't worry about that. If you see the paint bucket, hold and click, just hold down the click and you'll get this little list come up and click gradient tool. From here we're going to go all the way up to the top, and just, you see this black and white, that's the default, so you want to click that, and you want to click the name of this one right here, which is Russell's Rainbow. Now if you don't have that already loaded into your presets, don't worry about that. Just go to the top right hand side here and you'll see this little cog, click that and the drop down menu will come up. From here you just want to go and click special effects and then go and click append. Make sure you click append and not OK, otherwise it'll take all the rest away. So once you have done that, click OK. Now from here, depending on if yours is portrait or landscape, you really have to play around with the gradient tool here. So wherever you want yours, you really have to go from where you want to start to where you want to end. So before we do that, we're going to go to the top right hand side around here, and we're just going to go and click the radial gradient, so click that. Make sure that you haven't got the linear gradient on, because otherwise it won't work. We need it to be a circle. So from here we're just going to go from where we want it to start, drag upwards to where we want it to end, just let it apply, and there you go, that's basically your rainbow start. Now obviously it isn't in the right place, you will have to play around with this quite a bit to get it to where you want it. Now don't forget you can press Ctrl Alt and Z to undo, and just try it again until you get it right. So we can go back again, like I said, Ctrl Alt and Z, and just try again to wherever you want it. That's a bit small, but obviously we can work on that. So from here, once you have got your rainbow into position and where you want it, we're going to go over and choose screen on the drop down menu over here on the left hand side. From here we're going to go up to filter, and then we're going to go over to blur and Gaussian blur. Now you want a radius of 50.3 pixels, that's basically what I'm going for. You can really play around with this bit if you want. Click OK, and it once it's done, then from here we're going to go and add a layer mask. Now go to the bottom right hand side and you'll see a little image that looks like a camera, just click that and you'll get this white piece of paper right here that comes up next to it. Make sure that you have got that ticked on, and we're going to go back up to the gradient here where we selected Russell's Rainbow, and we're just going to go and click just this one here, it's the black and white one, and then click OK. But make sure that you have linear gradient and not the radial gradient for this one. So from this bit we're going to go and drag upwards from the bottom of the image to where you want your rainbow to start. So you might have to do this a few times like there. So if you want your rainbow just to come above the trees, so just go mark just above the trees and then go upwards. So once you have done that and you have played around with it and you've got your rainbow in the right position and it looks fine, now that suits the image, kind of, that's fine, but you might want to play around with the levels to get a little bit darker depending on your image, as I said. Now from here we can brighten this up, so we're going to duplicate it. So we're going to go and press Ctrl and J, and that duplicates, and we're going to go back to the bottom one, and we're going to drop the opacity down to around about 70%, or you could just go lower and lower if you feel that's too strong. Now don't forget, this is a bit too bright for this image, but you will want to duplicate if you have a lighter image. As this is a pretty dark image, we can drop both the opacities down, and you want to play around with the blending options for this, as loads of different ones work really well for this. So like, let's just go through them. So we got that one, for instance, that's overlay, and even this one, you've got soft light. So don't just you know, stick to what I'm telling you, the options I'm telling you. Play around with it, see what you can create, and basically let it suit your image. If you need it a bit darker, you can press Ctrl and L, and that brings up the levels palette, and you can really just darken that to suit the image. So let's just bring that over here, and we can darken that to around about there. I'll be okay for this image, and there you go. It's pretty simple, it's quick, it's easy, and it's a really realistic effect. So don't stop there, play around with it, see what you can create, and that's pretty much for this tutorial, guys. I'll see you in the next one, and please check out the website, please comment, rate and subscribe, and I'll see you next time, guys. Bye for now.